We have an America no one wants to talk about.
The love child of Lady Liberty and oppression.
The system's best kept secret.
Black boys etched into concrete.
Stories of rice fields and rough palms.
We are the broken promises and the crevices of the American dream.
Speak the native of my tongue so I can enunciate the words.
I am American.
My mother says America is the sea of opportunities. But what happens if blood is thicker than water?
You'll make me salute the flag every morning under God, try to burn the red, white, and blue into my heart.
But my heart rate quickens at the sight of police lights that shine the colors of my country.
Because so many of my brothers have seen their futures in palace cuffs and jail cells.
I'm just another black boy.
Don't wear black hoodies at night.
Jail Martin.
Speak louder.
Michael Brown.
Don't have asthma.
Eric Garner. Don't
have asthma.
We will no longer pledge allegiance to our flag.
We pledge allegiance to the bandana, and let the gate from Chicago to Atlanta.
And to our enemies, for which they stand.
We sling the bullets like how kids fling rubber bands.
It's our nation, so forget about God.
Because in reality,
there's no justice for a kid like me.
10'9".
You have a black male.
6'1".
Black hoodie. Your appearance should not be based on the future of your actions.
Where you hang.
Let me see your hands.
Instead of a question that becomes difficult, making your heart feelings to breathe, worse to enunciate. Nerves in effect.
My hands becoming moist.
My body begins to shake.
Did I do something wrong?
Both hands in the air only symbolizes the freedom that we no longer have.
No, the gun need be placed on a host of patients, but eager to draw to spit a pile of another human's life.
Don't move! I'll shoot! Don't move!
This particular phrase creates a flashback.
Just thinking of a life that I always hated.
But the fear of a bullet changes my mind in a matter of 10 seconds.
I begin to cherish bad breakups, apologies that I once regretted. The Martin Luther Kings that believe that justice is still needed. So my mind comes to second to my life. My soul evaporates into the sky. In 3, 2, 1.
We have America no one wants to talk about.
Black girls know their Barbies well. 10 to the blonde locks like prayer. Like maybe if God made me a little more lighter, I would be beautiful. My mother straightens every kink and curl that has ever gained enough confidence to blossom.
I don't believe in pretty. My Barbies lack my café con leche skin and thick thighs lead to a cellulite. I inherited my grandmother's Dominican sway, causing too much male attention to the parts of me that developed too quickly for my age. Considered woman before I was finished being a girl, I wonder if she feared the wandering eyes and intrusive hands of men who know women as
mother,
sister,
girlfriend,
that she's a female body as her plaything, never human, just a man's vacation. My mother would now spend the rest of her life unintentionally shaping my body. When will you fix your hair?
I just showing to her skin.
You have to look respectful with Sunday service. I don't want the pastor to talk. Learn to love my body. But how many teen girls have killed themselves trying to fit the American dream?
We have America no one wants to talk about.
No one wants to talk about how sexualizing women is just another accessory to rape.
One chain, one country turning my trail of tears into a trail of blood.
Why are we so scared of the White House slowly turning black?
Remember that not talking about us won't make us go away.